Allow me to introduce this video by painting a picture for you. It's late, you're home alone and sitting at your desk. It's dark outside, and the room that you're in is illuminated only by a small lamp. The faint sound of a cricket chirping can be heard outside. You're 2 hours deep into a Minecraft play session. Coordinates unknown, you are very far away from base and deep in a dark cave, spelunking. You approach a large opening in the cave, torches quickly becoming scarce. You can barely see 3 blocks ahead of you. Suddenly, a jarring cave sound plays. A sense of dread overcomes you. You open the menu, hit save and quit. That's enough Minecraft for tonight, you think to yourself. Hello and welcome, my name is Hocus, and in this video we are going to be exploring Minecraft's unintentional horror. A quick Google search will inform you that the best-selling game of all time, Minecraft, is a sandbox survival video game. No mention of horror. Despite this, many players report that Minecraft is a scary game, and it is certainly not uncommon to be frightened whilst playing in your infinite, procedurally generated world. Personally, I've had my fair share of spooks whilst playing Minecraft. In fact, I can still remember the first time that I was scared by the game and the effect that it had on me. Way back when I first heard about Minecraft in the alpha days, I longed to download and play. At this stage in my life, I was too young to have a job and therefore could not afford to purchase the game. Allegedly, I eventually stumbled across a cracked version of Minecraft and I was finally able to have a go for myself. On my very first night, I dug into the side of a mountain for protection, leaving only a 2x1 opening so that I could see out into the darkness. Those of you that played in alpha will know that the game was extremely dark, and will therefore understand that whilst pondering the vast pitch blackness of my first night, I was unable to see a skeleton standing merely blocks away from my hidey hole. The classic bow and arrow sound bellowed out as the skeleton tagged me, taking me completely by surprise. This moment terrified me, and the sound of the bow and arrow was enough to make me jump out of my skin. I'm embarrassed to say that this skeleton petrified me so much that I played exclusively on Peaceful for at least 2 years following the incident. So, other than spooky skeletons in the night, where does Minecraft's unintentional horror come from? There are many characteristics of the game that contribute, but the ones that I like to focus on are darkness, loneliness, liminal spaces, mob design, and urban legends surrounding the game. As mentioned in the introduction, Minecraft can be a dark game. In the literal sense, even in more recent editions. This is an obvious horror aspect, but most of those scared of the dark aren't necessarily scared of the darkness itself, it's more of a fear of that within. This makes Minecraft's mob spawning system the perfect way to target nyctophobia. That's the fancy term for an extreme or irrational fear of the dark. Every block in Minecraft has a light level indicated by a number from 0 to 15, 0 being the darkest light level, and 15 being the brightest light level. Monsters are only able to spawn in areas that have a light level that is equal to 0, which means that, by nature of the game's mob spawning rules, you're virtually always unaware of what is lurking in the dark. Being a sandbox game, Minecraft provides the player with a plethora of available activities. One of these activities, and a core gameplay loop, is spelunking, the exploration of caves. These dingy caves are home to valuable ores and minerals, which allow for progression in the form of weapon and armor upgrades. One of the most sought-after ores in the game is diamond ore, which can be used to craft the strongest gear available to the player. Diamond ore is rare, and can only be found in the deepest, darkest crevices of Minecraft's sprawling cave systems. If you still can't see where I'm going with this, I'll summarize it for you. As a means to progress, Minecrafters are forced to explore dark caves for the valuable loot that can be mined within. This means that the player will have ample opportunity to face the darkness and whatever uses it to shroud itself, which is generally a host of hostile monsters that want nothing more than to ruin your spelunking session. With that said, is it reasonable to use the term nyctophobia in the context of Minecraft? I'm not sure that having a fear of the dark can be described as irrational in this game. Have you ever felt alone in Minecraft? I don't mean in the obvious sense that you are the sole inhabitant of an extremely expansive world. I mean the gut-wrenching feeling you get deep in your stomach when you abruptly become conscious of being alone and you begin to experience apprehension, almost as if you are being watched by someone, something. This is known as the psychic staring effect and has been reported by countless Minecrafters as something that they have experienced whilst playing the game. I've even had this feeling myself. The psychic staring effect is a phenomenon in which humans claim to be able to detect being stared at by extrasensory means. This idea was first explored by psychology professor Edward B. Titchener in 1898, who stated that students in his junior class believed that they could feel when they were being stared at from behind. A smaller proportion of Titchener's students also believed that by staring at the back of a person's neck, they could use the phenomenon to force them to turn around. As mentioned, I have experienced the psychic staring effect in Minecraft myself, and, for me, the feeling is amplified when playing on a low render distance. The claustrophobic fog truly makes for a foreboding atmosphere in the game. A further phenomenon often experienced in Minecraft is the liminal space effect, another that creates a horrifying atmosphere for the player. Liminal spaces have always existed, but have only recently been defined following the rise of popular internet stories, such as the Backrooms. I will now show you a series of liminal screenshots from Minecraft, and I really want you to think about the type of emotions that they elicit. Liminal spaces are defined as those in a state of change or transition and often appear eerie, unsettling, and sometimes surreal. Many agree that the liminal space effect is heightened in screenshots from earlier versions of Minecraft, and I tend to agree. The liminal space effect can be experienced in real time and not only through a still image, meaning that players can often encounter a liminal space within their Minecraft world. This leads to the aforementioned feelings washing over the player, enhancing the accidental horror of Minecraft in otherwise innocent situations. Now, this is a little bit controversial because there is a strong argument to suggest that this aspect of Minecraft is wholly intentional. Mob design. Before I proceed, I'd like to remind you that Minecraft has a 7+ age rating. Therefore, for this segment, I'll make the perhaps fragile case that mob design in Minecraft is, at worst, willful ignorance on behalf of the developers. In general, the mobs in the game are thematically horror-based and are staple villains of the genre. Skeletons have appeared countless times in horror pop culture, with a good example being the junkyard scene in Russell Chuck's 1987 cult classic, A Nightmare on Elm Street 3, Dream Warriors. Zombies, still terrorizing the big screen today, were popularized by George A. Romero's 1968 Night of the Living Dead, and spiders had their big break as a horror antagonist in Frank Marshall's 1990 Arachnophobia. Other adversaries in Minecraft are instead derived from urban legends that fall under the horror umbrella. The best example of this is the Enderman, which is based heavily on the Slenderman creepypasta. Notice the likeness in name and appearance. The similarities even extend as far as behavior, both Slenderman and Enderman having the ability to teleport. A couple that don't have such obvious roots are the Creeper and the Warden, and both of these mobs seem deliberately geared towards inciting fear within the player. Creepers are designed to be completely silent until within range of the player, and are therefore able to sneak up on you unexpectedly. Once in range, they will let out a large hiss before exploding in the player's face, causing damage. Essentially, creepers are giant, green, four-legged jump scares. Recently added to Minecraft, the Warden may be a scarier, yet more infrequent, encounter than the Creeper. Only able to spawn in the deep dark biome, a bad start, the Warden locates its prey, the player, via sound and smell. Once located, the player is plunged into even further darkness by the Warden than already being experienced whilst in the ill-lit depths of the world. This mob hits hard, is extremely resistant to damage, and looks like this. In conclusion, a walking nightmare. In August of 2010, a post was made to the paranormal board on 4chan suggesting the existence of an entity known as Herobrine in Minecraft. The post detailed strange encounters with the digital ethereal being, even noting that it was able to create structures, such as pyramids, and dig tunnels in the world. It was rumored that Notch, Minecraft's creator, had a dead brother, and he was able to transfer his soul into the game in order to haunt players in the form of Herobrine. Many videos exist of Herobrine encounters, but it's best to be careful when navigating them. Some of them contain jump scares. I've fallen for this myself in the past. By and large, Herobrine is described in two ways by Minecrafters that claim to have met him in-game. Either he stalks the victim, remaining as close to the render distance fog as possible and will disappear when pursued, or he acts in a vengeful manner, attempting to trap players, kill players, and sometimes causing the game to crash following the player's death. Since all of the media attention surrounding Herobrine in the early 2010s, Notch has made the following statement. "I've publicly told people there's never been any such thing as Herobrine, and that I don't have any dead brothers." Although, up until Java Edition 1.16.2, Mojang would always reference the removal of Herobrine from the game in the changelogs as a running gag. Whether Herobrine exists or not, this creepypasta had an effect on me personally, and I remember telling friends about the story and having them accompany me as I ran around freshly generated worlds hoping to encounter this elusive being. In fact, after first reading about Herobrine whilst playing alone, this knowledge certainly amplified my feeling of being watched, earlier discussed as the psychic staring effect. I would often spook myself into shutting the game down for the night, as I was convinced I would eventually catch a passing glimpse of Herobrine staring at me from the render distance fog. Although Minecraft's horror may not be intentional, it's certainly palpable. Some aspects of the game, for example mob design, spawning mechanics, and lighting, certainly seem designed to instill a feeling of terror in the player to some degree. However, Minecraft's age rating of 7+ makes me skeptical that these horror aspects were implemented with the purpose of anything more than surface level spooks, despite often exceeding this expectation. Before you go, I'd like to thank you greatly for watching this video. I really appreciate you being here. Make sure to hit the like button if you enjoyed it, and let me know about any horrifying experiences that you may have had whilst playing Minecraft in the comments section below. Most importantly though, keep your base well lit, stay out of the deep dark, and keep an eye on the render distance fog. You never know who or what is watching you.